generation of the love sin and the hate God. You know what you sinners have? You sinners have a sin-loving, God-hating heart. God-haters! God-haters! You know it's easy to love God. It's easy to love God. He's kind, he's loving, he's forgiving. He's full of grace, but you know what? You make him angry. You make him angry. You make him angry because you're full of the devil. You would rather be a whore than be a pure princess of God. There is not a righteous person out here. You guys are very unholy, very profane. You know what you remind me of? You know you remind me of? A garbage can. You're like a garbage can. You know what happens when you don't take out the garbage? It fills up with a bunch of milk. It overflows. It overflows. When you don't take out the garbage, it begins to stink. That's like you sinners. That's like you sinners. You're like garbage cans. You fill up with filth, and then it overflows, and everybody has to bear your filth. You know what? Things are going to change. Things are going to change, sinner. When you go to stand before Holy God, you're not going to have all these sinners around you to prop you up, sir. It's going to be you.
Amen.
And you sinners don't think ahead. You sinners don't think ahead. You just take up your dead hands, and you know what you do? You go and run somebody over and kill them because you're a drunk driver. You're a very hateful person. You know what this dirty old man does? This dirty old man makes merchandise of women. He makes merchandise of women. You know what? I have a beautiful wife and I love her and I'm pure. You don't have that testimony because you're a loser. You're a loser. You women, is this how you want it? Is this how you want it to be made merchandise of? Horny men? Is this how you want it? Where's your dignity? How much have you sold your purity for? What's the price of your purity? Yeah, your purity's worth nothing to you. Your purity's worth nothing to you. You know what? What's wrong with holiness? What's wrong with holiness? What's wrong with being pure until you're married? You know why you think that being pure until you're married is worthless? Because you're on the devil. The devil's in you. The devil's in you, woman. You're a dirty old woman right there. No. And he's going to say to you, sir, depart from me, cursed, in the everlasting fire. You, look at the foolish men around you. Look at the dirty women. Are you going to make merchandise of all these people? Are you going to let the devil make merchandise of you? What is your soul worth? What is your dignity worth? There's not an ounce of dignity out here. There's not an ounce of dignity. Look, you're someone's daughter. How does your dad feel that you've sold your dignity and your purity for nothing? You're failing. something. Maybe they are professionals in the world, so what? If they lose their soul, you've lost everything. I'm not going back to sin. You guys are losers. Why would I want to be like him? He's profane and violent. Why would I want to be like him? He's got nothing going on. This guy's got nothing going on. Do you want to be like this guy? Do you want to be profane like this guy? I think maybe God can deal in your life. You are seeing a separation from light and dark. You're seeing a spiritual battle outside you and beyond. This might be for you. World. He hasn't punished you after your sins deserve. He is willing to give you the gift of eternal life, a free gift. Why wouldn't you take it? What sin is worth so much to you that you wouldn't take the gift of eternal life? What sin is worth so much to you? Is it worth losing your soul for? You know, if you go to hell, you're going to be there for a long time. The Bible says if a worm never dies, the fire is never quenched. Everlasting torment! That's what you have to look forward to. But the answer is simple. Jesus died. But there's a condition. There's a condition. Your life belongs to him from now on. Are you willing? Make the decision right now. Okay, maybe I misread. Maybe you're just a silent rebel. Maybe you're just a silent rebel. Okay, well, maybe we don't have one. Maybe you'll just go to hell with all the fools then. I'll just leave off. Maybe you weren't worth God's time. I'm sorry. So moving on, the Bible says that the road to destruction is broad, and you're all on it. You're all on the broad road that leads to destruction. Now let me tell you about the broad road that leads to destruction. There's pedophiles on that road. You know what? You are on the same road as a pedophile. The road of rebellion is the road of rebellion. The road of rebellion has liars on it. If all you did is lie your whole life, you're on the same path as the pedophile. Congratulations. You're going to go to hell with the pedophiles. You're on the same road as Adolf Hitler. You're on the same road as Adolf Hitler. What kind of a man was Adolf Hitler? A murderer. This man here murdered me in his heart. He wishes me dead. That man right there is a murderer. He murdered me in his heart. If this barricade wasn't here, I'd be dead. Most of you would kill me. So that murder, you're a murderer. God sees you as a murderer. That hatred in your heart for me, that's murder. It's murder in your heart. You're a murderer. You're going to go to hell with Adolf Hitler. So the broad road to destruction is littered with all kinds of horrid monstrosities like you. You sinners are monstrosities. You are monstrosities. You know what? A moral moron. A moral idiot. You know why? You know what? I'll give you an example. Morons are crazy people live in delusion. They live in delusion. They live in a fantasy land. Like transgenders. Transgenders live in a fantasy land. They think that they're a woman when they're actually a man. Now I'll show you how crazy this is. If I claimed to actually be Jesus Christ, and I tried to convince you that I was, you would say that I was crazy. And yet you accept the testimony of a transgender who's doing the very same thing. Oh, I'm a woman, when they're really a man. But you support it, you know why? It makes you feel righteous. It makes you feel righteous to support it. It makes you feel righteous. But I'm telling you people, all of your sins will be judged severely on the day of judgment. God is severe with sinners. Everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels.